Hi, and welcome to this tutorial about wheel deformation in Maya. I'm pretty new to rigging, and this was definitely one of the things that stumped me whilst I was trying to rig my BMW setup. Let's dive in. I'll show you first what it is that I'm going to teach you how to do, and then I'll begin the tutorial. So if we look here, we notice that the wheel is perfectly round. And obviously, in real life, this is not what a wheel looks like. We've got a lot of weight, gravity working, and pressure from the car bodies. So what I did was, when we translate into Y, we apply this pressure on the wheel, and we see how it goes kind of squidgy. So that's extreme, and then not at all. And it kind of just bops down, up and down, and inflates and deflates. Well, deflates I say, but if we look from this angle, we can actually see that it squishes more than deflates. So it's not losing any of that mass, it's just kind of puffing out. Squidging in and puffing out. So, let's move over to a new scene. And I will show you how to do this. Here we have a clean scene, so we've just got some basic parts of the rig and the root and the ground control and just the tire control for the front left one, because that's the one that I'll be working on. And when we go and translate Y, here we see it cuts through. And this might not be a problem if you don't mind about this during your animation. But having your car cut through the geometry, it's just not very realistic and not very appealing. So the other wheels we can see stay true to this ground control. They're not going to go through it, so it'll be a lot nicer to have that for the animator to just be able to drive the car around and know for sure that the tire isn't going to go through geo. So let's bring this back up and begin the tutorial. So we start with clicking the geometry of the wheel and make sure that everything is set. So it's all natural, nice and zero for translate and rotate, and one for the scales. Visibility of course on, and we can actually go in now and go to the deform of the top. Oh, I forgot to mention, if you're on the modeling for this, go to the rigging toolbar and then go to deform. From this we go to lattice and tick the option box. In the first three, well, squares, change the input to 10 and then tick local mode on. The local division should be 4. I think they're naturally set to 2, however when we use 4, it's going to be a lot nicer deformation, so definitely put it to 4. Center around selection, and root base and lattice together, so the others don't have to be ticked on. Transform all points, and just hit create. So now we have our lattice, and it'll make its own little group here. And what I suggest is to rename it to something that you'll understand, something that's clean and clear and just easy to spot. So I'll just do that now. Once we've renamed, just take them and pop them into the lattice group. If you don't have this group yet, don't worry, just make a new one. And I'm going to delete this. This just makes it easy to have everything together. And it's just a really quick and easy way to find things in your rig. So from this, we're going to select the lattice points of our lattice. Make sure it's not the base lattice, but the lattice you're selecting. And select the bottom points. Miss out the ones on the corners, since we won't want them. And when we move these, we can see it's going to give us some nice stretching, some nice squishing, but it's not going to be very nice for an animator to have to select these points. It's really messy, it's impractical, And, well, you just don't see it happening. So, let's move that back. And we can go to deform and cluster. Make sure it's relative and envelope one. And just hit create. So, the same as our lattice, just rename your cluster and pop it in a group. So, now it's in a group, we can control this with a cluster, but it's not giving us as nice of a deformation, especially when we get to here, it's kind of cutting off. It's pushing it up, but it's stopping at the points there, and here it's kind of like a peak, it's like a cone. So to fix this problem, we can go to deform and edit membership tool. Hit the shift and just select the points above the points you've already selected. And then just hit Q to go back and delete to see the results. So here we can see it's really nice. It's just giving us kind of an arc, which is quite subtle, just nice. Here it's kind of stretching more. It's giving us more of a natural curve. It's just aesthetically a lot more pleasing. So from this we can actually go and hide the lattice. So Control H in your outliner, and bam, it's gone. It's just gonna make it a lot easier, and the cluster still deforms everything. It's not gonna make any difference. It's just a lot nicer to work with this way. So now we select the control for our wheel, and I've already got my attribute here called tire pressure. To make this, just go to edit and add attribute. It's quite simple. Make the min 0 and the max 1. Now we go to edit and set driven key. Load driver as the control of your wheel and make your cluster the driven. We're going to use the tire pressure and make sure that your tire pressure is set to 1. So, I mean, set to 0. Not 1 yet. Set to 0. And just click on tire pressure. We're going to edit the translate X, translate Y, and scale X of your cluster. So just hit all of those so that it's nice and round and natural. Now change the tire pressure to 1. And edit your cluster. So before I did this, I played a lot with which settings I have to set, how many, like what values I have to make for everything. But since I've already done 4 of the wheels before this wheel, I know the exact values. So for me, the translate Y worked very well at 0.25. So I pop that in. The scale X. We do the scale X because we don't just want it to go up. It's going to lose its mass. The tire kind of puffs out when there's pressure on it. It almost balloons. So to make it realistic, we're going to have to scale it in the X direction or whatever direction works for you. So my scale X worked best when it was at 1.086. So I'll just change that to that. There we go. And then you see how here it's cutting through the rim. Well, we definitely don't want that because a rim is a hard set of geometry. So we're just going to translate the x in 0.03. Oops, I meant minus 0.03 for that. Obviously, if you're doing the other side, it will be 0.03. And now we can set the key. So translate Y and scale X. Now we click this control and we scrub through. We can see it's doing the deformation already. This is great. And you could keep it at this if you want the animator to just be able to control it like this and the tires to still be able to go through the ground. But I like to make it so that when you controlled it from the root, it's just not gonna go through the ground. I mean, it saves your animator quite a lot of work, and it saves them from having to key and do all that stuff. It keeps everything nice and clean. We can hide the control as well, so control H on our cluster. And bam! So close. So what I did was, I used an expression. You can access this through the top of the edge of the channel box. And bring that here, select filter. Obviously I've already done some, so I have it here. And delete this one. And you want to type in your control that you're going to use for the wheels. So mine is wheel front left underscore control. And then dot tire pressure, or whatever your attribute is called. And then you want this to equal your translate Y of the root control. So when you're writing out these expressions, it might be different for when you have an attribute. See where I have the capital T here? That's because that's what I've named my attribute, and therefore that's what it will take in expression editor. But for the translate Y of the root control, make sure that it's underscore T. Well, it's lowercase t and a capital Y, otherwise it might not take it. So just hit edit. Remember to finish your statement and then hit edit. It shows that it's been made, but there's going to be a few problems with this, because for one, it's inverse, so we're definitely going to have to times it by minus one. So let's do that, and then we can see it starts doing it, but it's not enough. So I know that for me it works very well when I did minus three. So bam. Just play around with those numbers, it might be different for you. But minus three is just what worked for me. And there we go. It's a simple. It stays with your tire when you rotate and move it. And your tire is can be set there. Set that there. Set that there. And then when we scroll through, we see there's a nice deformation. We don't have to key it. It just automatically happens. It's quite nice. This saves a lot of time for your animator. And I bet they'd appreciate it if you did it. At least I know I would if I was animating. Set this back, and that's all. So I hope this helped, and I hope you can maybe add some things, play around with it. I'm very new to this, so this is only very basic stuff, but it's a good basis for you to start, and it's definitely quite a handy little trick to know when you're rigging a car. So hopefully your car will be like this, and then it'll just go. Oof. So thank you for watching, and let me know if this helped you. Let me know if there's any other things that you're questioning about rigging a car. And yeah, thank you for watching.